In the semi-pro ukulele troubadour class, I signed up for online and took a diligent 6-week intensive that may have included an on-site retreat. It said always play first thing in the morning, hydrate with coffee, and if you play things right, you'll have construction workers disassembling metal scaffolding and the sound of trucks backing up, beep, 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 as a backing track. It's much less expensive than hiring in a yacht rock session musician and drummer. All this free advice. So I woke up this morning, the first message I saw was an acquaintance from Vancouver saying, "You know, I had some friends visit Japan. They didn't really have a good time. There was a lot of crowds, mostly Americans." Now this friend is from Canada, so they say Americans. This does not mean the hemisphere as a whole, but people from where, what they colloquially call the States. With a little bit of that classic Canadian condescension. There were lines, you see. There were lines at all the attractions. Because shrines and temples and people's cultural heritage are attractions. In which, unless they were going to Universal Studios or Disneyland. And my goodness, you cross a vast Pacific or Atlantic and continents to come to a historic archipelago and you go to those kind of places. But anyway, I've sent so many dispatches talking about my love of the minor provincial cities, the prefectures. Japan has 47 jurisdictions, prefectures for the most part. And then a few special jurisdictions like Hokkaido, which would be like a big territory. Anyway, and Kyoto and Osaka and Tokyo are special. And everyone goes to those three special places. So if you go to Kyoto, guess what you're going to find? A lot of tourists lined up with their backpacks, sweating in t-shirts, going, "Is this what the guidebook said? Is this where that person said to go on the Instagrams? Did we get that photo right? Why is nobody wearing shorts? Why is there no trash cans? Why is there no signs in English? Did you see that thing that everybody forwarded me saying there's a sign on a restaurant written in pencil that says in Chinese, 'No, we're full,' and says in English, 'Nope, we're all full up.' And then in Japanese says, 'Fine, if you can read this, you can come on in.'" One little paper sign gets all this attention. Instead, folks just spend an hour and watch my video I made with Renegade Ted, the tour guide, talking about all the places in Japan that are specifically not Tokyo, Kyoto, Osaka. That's how you have a good time. We've had many visitors here over the since the borders reopened. And there's all kinds of ways to have a good time. But I realize there's a bigger problem at foot here where this acquaintance did not see my numerous dispatches because we're spread out all over the internet. So I've got a little message. Just fax me instead. Put your schemes and dreams on a scroll. A long, warm, and slow. With that crackling sound. You know, I know the guy who made the toner fixer. Anyway, that's a digression. You see, I'm disenchanted and disinclined about clicking buttons just to prove that I like you, because I probably, certainly, definitely, likely, perhaps, do. How many buttons have we clicked about each other over the decades? Oh. So, facts me instead. But postcards and telegrams are also accepted. And when I say telegram, I mean delivered by a chap in a cap. Not the app. Yeah, I don't want to sign up for another prehistoric service that's run by, data geeks out of a basement where much of the internet, the best parts of the internet, were created. Small data centers, you know, I have a history of what it takes to stack up your own servers and modems. I know how that part of the internet is made, but automatic is just eating its community. And I see a dozen more ways to publish. And no. I do not have a Substack you can sign up for. But just for kicks, I went and posted a thing on LinkedIn the other day. And after figuring out how to log in and figuring out how to post things and seeing all the stock messages. On this holiday season, I wish the best for you and your family. From the last 6 years. From folks I... Perhaps we exchanged business cards. Is this converting for you? Is this your funnel? So less funnels and more fun. And I know you pals in Canada are going, well, you know, actually, Canada Post is on strike. Well, you know, actually, Japan should be made just like an amusement park because we're building the economy. You know, when Japan was closed to tourists, there were a significant amount of people said, do we really have to reopen the borders to tourists? Like 2-3% of the economy. Like, I want everyone to come. But take a few minutes, do some research and say, what does Japan have on offer? Because there's all these prefectures, all these places. Hello, here I am in Okayama. No, that's not Okinawa. That's not Osaka. That's not anywhere near Tokyo. But it's a fantastic city. We got a castle. We got a garden. We're the jumping off point to high mountain plateaus. And even better, an endless assortment of islands filled with modern art. Yeah, art installations of a world-class variety. And you know, I've made Creative Life Archive posts about all this stuff. Yup, you know, davostory.com. You've heard of it. You've meant to visit. You type in some words, or you click on field notes, and you'll see museums and trains, and you'll never see another tourist. We have Karaski here. After my wife's jazz gig a few weeks ago, the three of us, little Ichiro Stanley, walking through the historic Beacon area, which was a trading post since the Edo period. That's like the bald heads and the samurais and the feudal system where people were working so hard and the merchants and the... Anyway, beautifully restored, not as a theme park, but as an active, lively a district filled with jazz coming from courtyards and bars and cafes. Shops selling ceramics, denim, and stationery, paper. And I said, this is my place. Then we wandered down a back alley past a coffee shop that sells coffee, toast, and raw cheesecake. Like the whole place is custom made. This is my theme park. And we found down a little walking pedestrian laneway place making wood-fired pizza, and it came out with a mountain of prosciutto that Ichiro and Ryoko both went, look at this majestic mountain of prosciutto and arugula, which some people call rocket. So my message to you, my friends, is you can just fax me. But let's send letters. Remember when everyone was like, stuck at home, I'm making sourdough starter. I was getting tons of letters. It was really great. You'll find it super fulfilling. And if you just want to send letters, to do it. To go through the process, go to postcrossing.org. .org? I'm there as Devo. And you can get pen pal exchanges. Here's send a postcard to this person. And they'll get it and then they log it. It's like a blockchain for postcards. You see what I did there? Where you going? I don't mind. I've wasted my world and I've wasted my time. So where do I go? What do I see? I see so many people coming after me. So where are you going? I don't mind. If I live too long, I'm afraid I'll die. Here's the important part. So I will follow where you ever you go. If your offered hand is still open to me. Strangers on this on this road we are on. Here we go. This is what I want to do. We are not two, we are one. We are not two, we are one. I just want to hang out like we are in that old kind of group chat, checking in on each other, and not some kind of bright, loud discord. Commotion. How about some calm internet? How about a little bit more conversation? More hotcakes and fewer hotcakes. Addresses are now open. Postal workers are standing by.